Hi everyone, now we are going to see about Ohm's law and Kirchhoff's law. This is very very basic in circuit analysis. We must know about Ohm's law. If you are not knowing this, then we cannot do any other problem further. So Ohm's law states that the voltage across the resistor, which is directly proportional to the current flowing through the resistor. So V is directly proportional to I. This is called Ohm's law. So if you want to take the proportionality, there is one constant which needs to be introduced. So V is equal to I into R. R is the proportionality constant. So about R we have seen in the last video itself. It is called resistance. How this resistance will be used, everything we have seen already. So Ohm's law is V is directly proportional to I. That is V is equal to I into R. So the resistance R is an R capital R is an element which is denoting the ability to resist the flow of the current, which is measured in ohms. The unit of resistance is ohm. So if you want to find R when you are having the quantities of voltage and current, then R is equal to V by I. Instead, if you have length of the element or if you have the cross sectional area of the element, then you have to use the formula of rho L by A. And the conductance, we can see conductance, it is the ability of the element to conduct electric current, which is opposite to the resistance. Resistance is the ability to resist the flow of the current. Conductance is the ability of the element to conduct the electric current. So just opposite to the resistance, it is called conductance. It is also measured in mho, which is the inverse of this ohm, called mho, or you can tell as Siemens. So 1 by R is called as conductance. Then you should know what is branch, node and loop. So branch means it is a single element like voltage source or resistor, or like you can tell it is a capacitor, any element. If you look at this diagram, this is one branch, this is another branch, this is another branch. So this and all called a branch. A node, if you look at the node, it is a point from where multiple connection of branches is existing, like the point of connection between two or more branches. Here this is called a node which is having 5 branches, 1 2 3 4 5. This is called node. Loop, if you want to see loop, a closed path of the electric circuit is called a loop. This is called a loop. So closed path, that is called a loop. Then we are going to see about Kirchhoff's current law. This law states that the algebraic sum of the currents at a node is zero. Or you can tell, I have told this is called a node. Okay. So the algebraic sum of the current at a node is zero. This is called KCL or current law. So the current which is entering and which is existing, you take the algebraic sum of all the currents which is equal to zero. You can tell like this, or you can tell in another way, which is the sum of current which is entering into the node equal to the sum of the current which is exiting the node. If you look at this diagram, I1 current is coming inside to the node, I2 is going outside of the node, I3 is the incoming current, I4 is the outgoing current, I5 is the outgoing current. So if you write the incoming current, sum of incoming current, I1 is incoming and I3 is incoming. So I1 plus I3, which is equal to I4, I5 and I2. So if you write, you can write like this, or you can write like this also, like the current whichever is coming inside, you can give the plus symbol, and whichever is going outside, you can give the negative symbol. So I1 is coming plus, I2 is going outside negative, then I3 is coming plus I4 is going outside minus I4, I5 is going outside. So you can give the symbols of incoming and outgoing. Outgoing will be negative and incoming will be positive. So this is called Kirchhoff current law. If you will go for next law, Kirchhoff voltage law, it is almost the same, but it will be working for the closed loop. Algebraic sum of the voltages around the closed path is zero. So this is voltage law. So this is the law for voltage. Here also the algebraic sum of all the voltages around the closed path is zero. You can take either in clockwise or you can take either in anti-clockwise. So if you look at here, we can start with the voltage from clockwise direction. You can give the symbol, which is V1 is negative, then V2 is positive, then V3 is positive, then V4 is negative, then V5 is positive. If you just add or sum all these values with the sign, which is equal to 0 according to this voltage law. Or you can rewrite like this, sum of the voltage drops, which is equal to sum of the voltage rise. If you take this negative values or voltage drop, which is equal to sum of the voltage rises, you can write like this. So we can see some problems with this voltage law, current law and Ohm's law. We will see in the next video. Thank you.